So today we will discuss about some basic formulas of the derivative. So already know that in last lecture we have seen some examples depends upon the derivative. So today we will see some difficult example related to the derivative. So example number first, differentiate, main question is that differentiate the following function with respect to x. First, under root of 2x plus 3 divided by 3x minus 1, its cube, its power 5, here 5x minus 2. Let, how to solve this? So this is a very difficult term. How to find its derivative with respect to x? Let this function call as y. Y is equal to under root of 2x plus 3 to the power 5 divided by 3x minus 1 its power 3 5x minus 2. Taking, so this is a very difficult term, so it's very, so there is no any standard formula to solving this. So firstly, we will simplify this using the logarithm. So taking log on both sides log y is equal to log of here 2x plus 3 to the power 5 divided by 3x minus 1 5x minus 2 here power 3, and we know that what is the meaning of this under root. Under root means what? That is 1 by 2. So after that we know that rules of logarithm. What is the rules of logarithm? If there is terms is in that way, that is log of x to the power n times log of x means what? If there is log x to the power n, this can be written as n times log x. So this is a, suppose this x is suppose this bracket and this power n, it's that is a 1 by 2. Hence log y is equal to 1 by 2 log 2x plus 3 to the power 5 divided by 3x minus 1 raised to 5, here 5x minus 2. After that, this 1 by 2 as it is. So log of, again we know that this rule, log of a by b, that is log a minus log b, 1 by 2 2x plus 3 to the power 5 minus 3x minus 1 to the power 3 5x, this bracket close. Log a by b means what? Log a by b. So this 2x plus 3 to the power 5 call as a divided by 3x minus 1 to the power 3 into 5x minus 2 call as b. So log of a minus log b, or sorry, log a by b means what? Log a minus b, or here log take as a common. Here log, okay, sorry, here log a and here log b. So log a minus log b. So this 1 by 2 is a comma. Here log 2x plus 3 to the power 5 log. Again, we know that log a into b means log a into log b. Log, so this is a minus, multiply to this, so you will get here 3x minus 1 to the power 3 minus log 5x minus 2. So again, by using this rule, log x to the power n times log x, so you will get here 5 log 2x plus 3, 3 times log 3x minus 1 log 5x minus 2. So we will simplify them. So this 1 by 2, this 5. What is the derivative of this? After that, after this step, we will take its derivative, differentiating with respect to x. Because these terms are very easy to calculating the derivative. Hence, here log y. So 1 by y. What is the derivative of log is 1 by y, and derivative of y is the dy by dx with respect to x. So this 1 by 2. This 5 as it is. So what is the derivative of this log? That is 2x plus 3. Again, this is the derivative of log. Again, take the derivative of 2x plus 3. 2x plus 3 is the 2. This 3 as it is. What is the derivative of this log? 3x minus 1. Again, what is the derivative of 3x? Is a 3, and derivative of 1 is the 0. What is the derivative of this 5x minus 2? Derivative of 5x is the 5, and derivative of 2 is the 0. So simplify this term, you will get the last answer. If there is any term is very difficult and it is applicable for logarithmic function, then have to firstly apply the log, then have to simplify it, which will easy to take the derivative. So after completion of this first example, we will see the example number second. Example number second is the find the derivative of sine x to the power log x divided by 1 plus x square. So it's very hard example after if you not simplify them with the, by using the log. Firstly, you have to apply the log for easy simplification, then take its derivative. If you are taking direct derivative, then it's very hard for solving its derivative. So for this, you have to apply logarithmic function. So here, take the derivative with respect to x. This called as let, this called as y sine x to the power log x divided by 1 plus x square. Taking log on both sides, we get log y is equal to log sine x to the power log x 1 plus x square. So log sine x to the power log x divided by log of 1 plus x square, log a by b, log a minus log b. So this term is very easy for calculating the derivative, but to solving these terms with respect to x. Again hard. So for this, again we will simplify them. Log x into log psi x, because we know that log x to the power n means n times log x. For this, so this power shift that side, and remaining term is log sin x minus log 1 plus x square. So here apply u into v root, because you are taking the derivative with respect to x. So this is a this contain x, so this is also contain x, so this call as u and this call as v. U into v, apply the u into v root. So log x as it is. What is the derivative of this log sin x? Derivative of log is the cos x. So u into v, first as it is, derivative of second. Next, second as it is, log of sin x as it is, and derivative of this log x is the 1 by x. See here, first as it is, derivative of this log x is the sin x. Again here, d by, this is the derivative of log, again derivative of the sin x here. Next, log sin x as it is, and derivative of x is the 1 by x. Again, derivative of x with respect to x is the 1. So again, I will write here, see, log x as it is, derivative of second, 1 by sin x, again derivative of sin x, plus second as it is, log sin x as it is, derivative of log x, that is 1 by x. This is the u into v. First as it is, derivative of second, plus second as it is, derivative of first, minus derivative of this simple term, 1 plus x square. Derivative of log is 1 upon some, that term. Again, d by dx of 1 plus x square. So this log x as it is. So 1 upon sin x. And derivative of sin x is the cos x. So log sin x 1 by x as it is, minus 1 upon 1 plus x square, and derivative of x square is the 2x, and derivative of 1 is the 0. So log cos x by sin x plus log sin x into 1 by x minus 2x 1 plus x square. So here we are taking derivative from this. Here y. Here derivative is 1 by y and dy by dx. So here 1 by y dy by dx. So this can be written as here log x, cos by sin means what? Cot x, log sin x, 1 by x, minus 2x, 1 plus x square. After completion of this example, we will see the example number 3. E to the power 3x sin square x into log x. So let y is equal to e to the power 3x sin square x into log x. Taking log on both sides, we get. So firstly, log y log e to the power 3x sin square x into log x. So we know that log of a, b, c, its meaning is what? Log a plus log b plus log c. So log y as it is, you will get log e to the power 3x log sin square x and here log x. So we know that same log x to the power n means what? N times log x. Hence log y 3x log e 2 times, so this 2 shift that side, log sin x. So log of x. So e and log, its value is 1. 3x 2 log sin x log x. So this is the easy terms. After that, we will take its derivative. Differentiating with respect to x on both sides. So derivative of log y is the 1 by y. Again, derivative of y is the dy by dx. Derivative of 3x, 3 is a constant. Derivative of x with respect to x is 1. 2 as it is. Derivative of this log is the 1 by log is the 1 by sin x. Again, derivative of sin x is the cos x. Derivative of log is the 1 by log x. Again, derivative of this log x is the 1 by x. So we'll simplify them. 1 by y dy by dx is equal to 3 plus 2. Cos by sin means what? Cot x. And here x log x into x. 1 by log x into x. So this is the complete exam. Number third. Example number fourth. That is y is equal to sin x to the power 1 by tan x. So same way, apply the log. Log y is equal to log sin x to the power 1 plus tan x. So using the logarithm, 1 plus tan x log sin x. So this is a function, this contain x, this is also contain x. Apply even to v rule. First as it is, tan x derivative of second plus second as it is log sin x as it is dy dx of 1 plus tan x. So 1 plus tan x derivative of this 1 y sine, again derivative of sine x plus log of sine x. Its derivative, derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of tan is the x square x. So 1 plus tan x 1 by sine x, and derivative of sine x is the cos x. So log sine x into x square x. Here y, log y, so its derivative is 1 by y dy by dx. 1 by y dy by dx. So I will give some example how to try. In next lecture we will start the directly syllabus of the M3, that is unit number first, Laplace transform. So this is a basic, you have to require the M3. So I have taken the lecture depends upon the basic knowledge related to the M3. So you have some example, try in your home. Y is equal to xx to the power 2x. Example number 6, y is equal to x into tan x to the power sec x. Next, x to the power x plus tan x to the power x. Sine inverse x to the power x plus x into cos inverse x. So everyone, in last lecture, next lecture we will see starting of the M3 directly syllabus. The name of that unit is the Laplace transform. So for this we have to require the formulae related to trigonometry, that is sine a sine b, cos a cos b, cos square, sine cube cos cube. So these all formulas are the very important. So everyone have to remember the trigonometric formulas. And the next unit, that is first unit of the M3, it's very big unit, because there are 7 properties in that unit. Again it's inverse of that 7 property, some special function. So this is a very big unit. So Laplace and inverse Laplace transform, so there are total 2 units depends upon this Laplace transform. So everyone be present to every lectures, कारण काय तो जो युनिट आहे लॅपलास ट्रान्सफॉर्म तो अतिशय महत्त्वाचा आहे. त्याच्यामध्ये एकमेकावरती प्रॉपर्टी डिपेंड्स आहेत. तुम्ही एक जरी लेक्चर मिस केलं असेल तर तुम्हाला तो चॅप्टर समजणार नाही. त्यामुळे सर्वांनी पहिल्यापासून एक एक गोष्ट लक्षात ठेवा. डेफिनेशन हे ते खूप लहान गोष्टी आहेत, खूप इझी चॅप्टर आहे, पण प्रेझेंट राहावं लागेल तुम्हाला, प्रत्येक लेक्चर अटेंड करावं लागेल, तुम्हाला तो एकदम व्यवस्थित प्रकारे चॅप्टर समजून जाईल. तो आपण पुढे पाहू पुढच्या लेक्चरमध्ये.